the lady that had did take care of it. And thank God for that. But still, they don't make it right.
18, that's how many years Glory Williams Pat raised Kamaya Mobley as her own daughter after kidnapping her as a baby from a Jacksonville hospital back in 1998. And today, Williams was sentenced to 18 years in prison, 1 year for each year she kept Kamaya away from her birth parents.
And Kamaya's biological family, they say they are relieved the legal process is finally over, but now it's time to rebuild the family. And we have live team coverage for you tonight. We begin with our Juliet Dreyer, who is live outside UF Health Hospital here in Jacksonville, where Kamaya was kidnapped nearly 20 years ago. Juliet.
Right, this is where this whole story began back in July 1998. Back then, this hospital was known as University Medical Center, and a 16-year-old named Shanara Mobley had just given birth, unaware that her baby girl would soon be taken. Today, both the judge and Kamaya Mobley's biological family said the same thing. There are no winners in this case. Shanara, do you feel like this was a fair sentence?
Shanara Mobley remains silent minutes after learning the sentence for the woman who kidnapped her baby girl almost 20 years ago. Inside, Kamaya Mobley's biological father read from a prepared statement.
I knew walking into this courtroom this morning that there would be no winners in this situation.
No winners in the case that captured attention across the world. Outside the courthouse.
Is there anything else, Craig, that you want to say?
Glad it's over.
Craig Aiken hadn't yet spoken to Kamaya, but planned to tell her that he loves her.
Is there any words that you have for Gloria Williams?
No, no comment on that.
I know she's sorry that this happened. I believe she's sorry, but it was a terrible thing that she did to her family.
Barbara Stewart is Shanara's grandmother, Kamaya's great-grandmother. She describes the pain Shanara felt for 18 years, not knowing what happened to her baby girl.
She always would think the baby was somewhere, didn't think the baby was dead, and she didn't know what to think. And now she should get a peace of mind now.
As for her great-granddaughter, Kamaya, Stewart believes she knows why she did not attend the sentencing.
She didn't want to be divided. She didn't want to be on one side or the other side. Because either side she would have been on, the next one, maybe some of the family wouldn't like that.
I asked Kamaya's great-grandmother what's next for the family, and she said togetherness. She said we need to get more togetherness, and I think everything's going to work out okay. Reporting live at UF Health Jacksonville, Juliet Dreyer, First Coast News on your side.
Juliet Dreyer, thank you.